Class of 2020, this is not the way we expected your senior year to end. But that's okay. Life is always very unscripted. You never know what's going to happen. My biggest pearl of wisdom, best advice I can leave you with, is approach everything with perseverance. There's going to be so many opportunities in your life where you can take the easy way out and walk away from something that's hard or challenging. That's not the route to success. Stick with the hard things. Push through that difficult college class. Mend a relationship. Communicate better with bosses and coworkers. Stay the course and you'll go on to wonderful things. You have such unique talents. This has always been an exceptional grade. I remember that first day of freshman connections. I can vividly recall your faces, scared, nervous, not sure of what laid ahead. We are so proud of you. We wish you all the best. And remember, in any opportunity, choose kind. Love, Ms. O'Shea.
To the class of 2020, I wish you nothing but the best with all your endeavors. I will truly miss seeing you guys in the hallway, but I know that you are going out into the world doing fantastic things. Farewell, you guys.
C.S. Lewis once said, "Integrity is what you do, even when no one is watching." What you do today, tomorrow, and in your future as you face every challenge truly matters. Remember, you're the historic class of 2020, and my heart is with you as you enter this new chapter of your life.
Hello, seniors. It's been really great to get to know you this year and last year. Some of you were in music this year. Some of you did music stuff last year. Some of you were in my advisory last year. That was really fun. And some of you have been doing a great job in the band this year. And some of you are named Daniel Davenport, who have carried the band this year, which is really helpful and great. I just wanted to say to you guys that I feel for you. It was not an easy year. I think the strike was a problem for a lot of you who did fall sports and stuff like that. That was an interruption. And of course, this time right now, that's taken away from your rites of passage, your prom, and your graduation ceremony, and that's a drag. I graduated from high school in the year 1999, so a lot was made of the last class of the century, and we were special and all this stuff. I did a lot of retrospective stuff about the whole century, and you're the last class of the century, blah, blah, blah. We felt special, briefly. And then the next year, when I came home from college in the spring and I read the stories in the paper about the year 2000 and how special they were because they were the first class of the new century, and it was the same thing, just another way to say that this class was special. And were they? Were we? I don't really know. But your class definitely is, because this hardship that you guys have endured this school year is something that can create a deeper sense of character and a deeper sense of the importance of enjoying the moments that we have together. You guys didn't know in the spring that you wouldn't get to do these other things. All of a sudden, oh, we're closed for 10 days, and then no, we're closed the rest of the school year. So I think that although it was painful at the time, if you guys can take that with you throughout the rest of your lives, that enjoy your friendships, enjoy your time with your family, enjoy the connections you make with other human beings the rest of your lives, then this period of pain and this period of hardship will not be for nothing. It will be something that you can build upon. And if you think about these sorts of things, I'll just close with this. The biographies of a lot of the great people, the Michael Jordans of the world, and people like this, their biography often has in it some sort of pain that that helped them reach their excellence. You know, there was something in their lives that they had to overcome, and then they were empowered by that, and they used that as a fuel to create more success. So I just wish the best to all of you. I had a wonderful time getting to know all of you, and stay in touch. I can't wait to hear about your success in the future. Good luck.
Hola, clase. I just wanted to give you all a quick shout out and tell you that it has been my pleasure to have been your teacher this year. I know that you are all going through a crazy time right now, but you are all truly living history right now. Make your mark. In a short 10 years, people will be studying the graduating class of 2020, and you can tell them how you did it with hard work and integrity. Los extraño mucho. Y si se puede.
Congratulations to the class of 2020. You guys did it. You graduated. And I'm so proud of all the strength that you guys have displayed over the past couple months. And I know without a doubt that that strength will carry on with you for the rest of your lives. I'm so thankful that my first year teaching, I got to teach you guys. Congrats, 2020. You did it!
Hi, class of 2020, it's Miss Marion here. I just wanted to send you my heartfelt congratulations and to actually leave you with two quotes that I think are very important during this time. They're both by Nelson Mandela. The first one is, "Education is the most powerful weapon which you can use to change the world." And secondly, "A winner is a dreamer who never gives up." My challenge to you is to always remember that your education at Chicago Ag Sciences has equipped you to change the world. And as a dreamer, you should never give up. Your dreams will come true. Do not put a period at the end of your dreams. Always have a comma. Congratulations.
You made it. Remember your success and failures. I love y'all. Keep growing and keep reaching for your dreams, no matter what. My favorite animal is the turtle. The reason is that in order for the turtle to move, it has to stick its neck out. There are going to be times in your life when you're going to have to stick your neck out. There will be challenges, and instead of hiding in a shell, you have to go out and meet them.
Hey guys. Congratulations to you, the class of 2020. We're so very proud of you and all of your achievements. Remember, the world is your cow, but you must do the milking. Take care.
Say congratulations to the class of 2020. Hope you had a eventful 4 years and a memorable 4 years. Good luck the rest of your life. Cheers.
2020 from the Chicago High School for Agricultural Sciences. You are about to be the historic class of COVID-19, the first virtual graduates at CHAZ. We are proud of your accomplishments. We are happy for this day. And as you move on to greener pastures, be the good that we want to see in this world. Be kind, share, be resourceful, be creative. A special shout out to Lauren, Gavin, David, Brian, Aldo, and Christopher, and all of the CHAZ graduates. Know that we, the staff at CHAZ, wish you well. We're happy to have known you and loved you and grown with you and learned with you for 4 years. Congratulations, class of 2020. Woohoo!
Chicago Ag, class of 2020. I'm excited to Zoom welcome you among an elite group of CHISAZ alumni. I've had the incredible opportunity to get to know you all over the past 3 years. In fact, some of you were there the very first day I walked into the shop as a teacher 3 years ago. I have to say though, in the past 3 years, you've come so far. When I first met you all as sophomores, I could not have imagined the incredible young adults that you would soon become. I've never been shy though about the challenges this class has presented. In fact, there have been times when this class has made me frustrated, upset, and angry. But those times are not to be outweighed by the times you have brought me joy, hope, and pride. In this way, perhaps you have taught me as much as I could have ever taught any of you. Class of 2020, I am proud of you and excited to see all the things you can accomplish with the bright future that is ahead of each one of you.
CHAZ, all grads, they are the best. Congrats, class of 2020, I'm cheering for you.
Shout out to the CHISAZ class of 2020. Appreciate all the fond memories I'll have of you all forever. You all were a class that tried me, but you all molded into some young adults that are going to help change this world. And I'm forever grateful to have known you and to have taught you. Reach out to me if you all ever need some assistance with anything. I sincerely appreciate the bonds that we've built throughout these years. Shout out to Advisory 006. Congratulations to you all. We were a mighty bunch and we slimmed down, and now you all across the stage. I know we didn't have Advisory this year, but I'm always in Advisory 006, the end of the alphabet. I'm always going to be your advisory teacher and always going to support you all in any of your endeavors. And so peace to you all. Keep your head up during these times, and Cyclones forever. Welcome to the club.
Hello, class 2020. This is Mr. Conrad here, just giving you guys a little shout out. Man, you guys had a real trying year this year, but you guys are going to be stronger because of it. You guys are tough individuals, okay? Don't let this deter you from accomplishing your goals, okay? You guys are the best, all right? I remember when you guys came in freshman year at Freshman Connection, and then I saw you guys in my classroom, most of you, and then seeing you guys in the hallways all grown up, after school activities, in sports programs. You guys are going to make a difference in the world, okay? A little shout out to my advisory, who I never got a chance to see as a group this year. Congratulations to everyone, and you guys are going to do wonderful things. Take care.
All right, class of 2020, this is my farewell speech to you. Met you guys, really, I guess, 3 years ago when I took over for Mr. Nelson and taught his class of environmental science, and I got to know many of you then, and I noticed right away you were a class with great personality. And then we did physics the next year, I think all of us, and I think we had fun there. We did some things that were interesting, unique, and we took a trip to Pullman with the Junior Academy, and hopefully introduced you to an interesting part of the city, and got you out of the school and taught you there's a lot of different ways to learn. I'm really sad that you guys are losing out on your prom and your graduation and your senior banquets and all those things, and hopefully you'll use those experiences to make you stronger and more compassionate towards others. On the upside, there's going to be a lot of science that comes out of this coronavirus. The research you're doing, the rate they're doing it, is going to yield some dramatic results, and we're starting to see those already. And that's going to be good for you in the long run. I think we'll be healthier in the long run. It's also showing us that taking care of your bodies and keeping them young and strong and in shape through exercise and hiking and biking and getting your stress level down is really important as you grow older. So make that a part of your daily routine to get out and find a trail or a bike path. There's so many in this area on the south side of Chicago that you can really get out and enjoy for pretty much the whole year. You've heard me talk about many of those things and have taken you to some of those places. And Camp Sag is a place that we've not only learned a lot, but I think had a lot of fun visiting. And these places are free and accessible to anybody who wants to go out there. So I just want to leave you guys just a positive message of hope that we'll get over this, and it will hopefully end soon. You guys have been through something very historic, and there's a lot that we're going to learn from this, and it's sad that it's had such an impact on your senior year, not to mention the strike that came before and all, but I just want to show you my graduation picture. This is 40 years ago. Do I look the same? No, maybe a little different, but the years go quick, and enjoy them, make the most of them, learn to be kind to others, and share kind, encouraging words to help heal people rather than cutting mean words to bring them down. And that's something that I think all of us can do, and doesn't cost a bit to help somebody in that way. So those are my words to you. I wish you the best, and just ask that you keep in touch with us and let us know the great things you guys are doing. Farewell.
From the studios of Farm Journal Broadcast, this is Action.
Hi, class of 2020. Congratulations on hitting this great milestone. What an accomplishment. You all enter in the world in an unprecedented time. And I have one simple message for you all. Remember to always stay true and keep the faith. You all will accomplish much. Mr. Desir.